Now, there's anger and confusion over an announcement from the government that it will send almost $5 billion to the UK to speed up production on the nuclear submarine program.
The dress code was high-vis as reps from the US, UK and Australia gathered in Adelaide for an initial heavy AUKUS announcement.
ASC and BAE will form a joint venture to build Australia's nuclear-powered submarines right here at the Osborne Naval Shipyard.
Those locally made AUKUS nuclear subs we keep hearing about will be a co-pro between Australia's government-owned ASC sub-builders and Britain's BAE systems, which, as Miles said, is a BFD.
These are big foundational decisions.
But construction can't begin until we get our grubby little hands on the nuclear components, which is why we're opening up the chequebook.
Australia will hand $4.6 billion to British industry.
We'll hand almost $5 billion to the UK.
$5 billion to the UK government.
The UK-based Rolls-Royce nuclear plant that makes the reactors needed for the subs is stretched super thin. So we're sending $4.6 billion to help them expand operations.
Obviously, the production rate of that facility needs to increase, and so in that context, it's completely appropriate that we are making a contribution to that.
Oh, that's nice of us, but that hefty contribution is not sitting well with everyone.
Sending some $5 billion of Australian taxpayers' money to the United Kingdom to prop up their failing nuclear industry. So they have been looking around the world for a sucker to subsidise them, and they've found the Albanese government.
This isn't even the first time we've done this. $5 billion is about the same amount we're giving to the US to bolster their submarine manufacturing.
Couldn't grab a cover, could I?
Of course. I'll just need $5 million to renovate the kitchen.
How much?
Your cup of tea will arrive in 2043.
So is it all just a normal part of doing business, or are we being taken for a ride?
Here to aim her nuclear-powered periscope at this issue is Latika Bourke. Latika, are we being suckered?
Look, this is the billion-dollar question because there are many concerns that AUKUS is a project that is so far away that what is being committed now might never see the light of day. The other concern, of course, is that this is largely a project that in its first phase will massively boost the United States submarine yards, it will massively boost the British submarine yards. Just what dividend that's going to pay for Australia, well, the plans are there, but what happens in reality is still a very live question.
Well, Latika, the AUKUS program is expected to cost us hundreds of billions of dollars over the next 30 years. Is this $5 billion, is it part of the amount we were expecting to pay, or is this an extra $5 billion?
So I have checked this, and the government says it's within the allocated expenditure for AUKUS. Oh. But you're right to ask this question. These sums are enormous. They're going to be eye-watering. And look, if you guys can show me a project within defence that has been delivered on time and within budget, let alone under budget, well, next round is on me.
But isn't this just life? Is it cost of living related? Like, bananas are more than they used to be. Submarines, an extra $5 billion. Isn't it the same thing?
Look, there is a very serious and strategic reason why Australia wants to acquire these submarines. If all goes well, we will have an incredible capability between the United States, Australia and Britain to be able to essentially constrain China within its sphere. And that is something that the three allies want to do because they want to ensure freedom of navigation. And what that basically means is that those bananas, those things that you import from other countries, remain at stable prices, because we know that if there are disruptions to the freedom of navigation, to shipping, everything on your plate ends up costing more. So that's basically what this is. This is a very long-term investment in ensuring the safety of trading around the world. But it is a huge gamble.
But Latika, the gamble with those long-term investments is that they may never happen. So what if this goes badly? Could we just have lost these billions and billions of dollars to overseas markets?
Look, this is a great question, and this is why the opposition, for example, has been asking for a specially dedicated oversight committee in the federal parliament that will actually oversee how AUKUS goes, because we are talking a program that's going to last decades. And as the Deputy Prime Minister Richard Miles said today, this is a forever program. So that's a lot of eggs in one basket.
We paid France $830 million to not build us some submarines. Is this a better or worse deal than that?
Well, come back to me in 20 years, guys, and we will know the answer to that. But look, one of the actual questions about this is whether by the time we want to be getting our homemade or tri-made submarines in the water, whether that's still actually the capability that's top of its game and is required. For example, we've seen in the war in Ukraine how they have actually used drones on boats to take out key assets in the Black Sea and sink Russian warships. So actually, there's a lot of room and space technologically over the next two decades, the same amount of time these submarines are going to be built, for new capabilities to be developed that actually could be cheaper. So I think over the next few months, the next few years, I'll be back here on the project talking to you guys about just how this project unravels.
Latika, thank you so much for taking us through it.
Always a pleasure, guys.
I think that's the first time I've cared about that kind of stuff.
Well, it's made sense.
Yes.
Latika makes it make sense.
Right? Yeah, when you just hear billions and billions and submarines, it all sounds make-believe.